Good morning, Cantina Dwellers. So today we're talking more about JW Rinzler's book about this guy, Howard Kazanjian, who was a producer on The Empire Strikes Back, Return of the Jedi, and other films. And this is the book, the cover of it. And Rinzler really did a great job. It's called A Producer's Life. And here is the quote. Kazanjian didn't say a lot, but he talked about The Last Jedi. He talked about what was wrong with the sequel trilogy. Now remember, these interviews took place before the rise of Skywalker. So the trilogy is still basically being developed because the last installment hasn't been put in. However, when you get people that worked on the original trilogy, like Howard Kazanjian and Marshall Lucas, ripping it, and he is ripping it, he talks about what a Jedi is and how the people who worked on these movies don't understand what they're doing and what they're saying. It's really, in my opinion, sad that we have to go through this, that we have to watch the people who were there at the beginning of Star Wars have to explain to the people coming in later that they're doing everything wrong. You know, Marshall Lucas had a lot to say about the prequel trilogy. I disagree with her on some of it. I kind of have an idea what George wanted to do. And, you know, he probably did need an editor like her and someone to stand up to him and say, this isn't working. We need to change some stuff around and do a different type of story here. But I also know what he's doing. So, you know, and the stories hold up. The sequel trilogy does not hold up. And Howard Kazanjian, who'd been there from the beginning, knows this too. I am not appalled by this. It's playing into Bob Chapek's hands, obviously. And it's making Kathy Kennedy look bad. It's strange that it's coming out now. It's too bad these feelings weren't out there in 2017. Especially Marshall Lucas's statements about Han and Luke and how valuable she intimated they are to the story. It's really just appalling to me that it took this long after the trilogy is done, for honest conversation to happen about the sequel trilogy. Now, Howard Kazanjian is going to be called, he is a misogynist, he's a racist and a bigot. He's basically attacking a movie with the protagonist is a pasty-faced British upper-crust chick, and the antagonist is a pasty-faced Paul Atreides wannabe. Okay. There's nothing of their sacred cows that the left wants to uphold in these movies. There's nothing about these sacred cows in either character. The minority characters like John Boyega, sectioned off on a little island and treated like basically a token because the Chinese audience. Kelly Marie Tran's character is dressed like Chairman Mao's fourth wife in a potato sack in The Last Jedi and relegated to a corner as well. Poe Dameron, I don't even really understand the point of his character even being in these movies. That's how bad they are. Okay, and I'm someone who's going in deeper than Kazanjian and Marshall Lucas did for the sake of what we're talking about. So when you hear somebody like whomever at Lucasfilm, probably in Pablo's private group, ripping The Mandalorian, for instance, ripping Gina Carano ripping Howard Kazanjian and Marsha Lucas. They're just exactly who Kazanjian and Marsha Lucas say they are. They don't understand Star Wars. They don't understand Jedi. They don't know what they're doing. Simple, easy, obvious. Okay. I don't need to explain that, I don't think. And here we are. Here we are talking about these movies that, in my opinion, should never have been made. They didn't need to be made. There didn't need to be a sequel trilogy. If you wanted to revisit the Star Wars universe, do stuff like Rogue One. Have the original cast members, you know, the original characters, the original heroes, show up in cameos every once in a while. That's fine. Have Vader show up every once in a while. Have Obi-Wan show up. Have Han and Luke and Leia. Okay, but you didn't need to do a sequel trilogy because it was over. And if you were going to do a sequel trilogy, either do it the right way or don't do it. Period. End of story. So now, the honesty and the conversations burst wide open. Now, first off, these conversations took place 2018. Okay, so that's 4 years ago, all right? Long after these movies are done, they're in the can, we know that, I mean, basically that Lucas got screwed over by Kennedy, and that's now been 2 years, 3 years ago. So this is just, I think, karma coming to visit. This plays right into Disney's hands. This plays right into the plan to remove problematic studio heads that aren't earning money. And go to an Ollie's. Go look at the shelves. If you see walls of Rays from TLJ, you know there's something definitely wrong with the franchise. And to the people out there who think Star Wars is dead, you can quietly go fuck yourself, okay? I'm done. Jon Favreau and Dave Filoni are doing a yeoman's work to fix it. You're either going to be loyal to the brand now, or you're not, or go do something else. Okay, I'm sick of it. Okay, we have to win this fight. And having these quotes come out now from Kazanjian and Marsha Lucas, it's huge. It's huge. Okay, so I want you all to think about how big this really has gotten. Okay? And it's very funny, again, that it ends up coming out right at the end of Kennedy's contract. I want you all to think about that. Right at the end of Kennedy's contract. Will she be renewed? Or will she get a one-year contract to finish Indy 5? I don't know. But I do know that this isn't that if Marsha Lucas is saying what she said, and she was very detailed, and if Howard Kazanjian is saying what he said, there are not just one or two others. There are hundreds in Hollywood right now saying the same thing. Dear SJWs, Kathy Kennedy, the Empress, has no clothes. She is nothing of who she thinks she is. J.J. Abrams is a failure, and he's lucky if he'll be able to keep his deal with Warner Brothers when Zaslav comes in as head of Warner Brothers. This is Steph signing out. See you around the galaxy. And oh, by the way, dear J.W. Rinzler, thank you for everything, and thank you for this. This was a gift to everybody who loves Star Wars. And we love you, and we'll never forget you. Godspeed, my friend. We'll see you in Valhalla.